As we now pray to hear us and be mindful that we are no way and judgment, and from all our souls in the bondage sin, your own compassion receive for us, accept us as we kneel before you, blind and familiar, I have sinned. We have been dependent on you from our mother's womb. You are our God, because our days have been vainly squandered. We are stripped of your help without any defense. Even so, encouraged by your words, we cry, remember not our sins committed in youth and ignorance, and purge our secret thoughts. Do not scorn us in old age when our strength fails us. Do not forsake us before we are repentant of our sins. Do not despise us of your mercy and grace. Measure out your words against our transgressions. Contrast the depths of your pity to the multitude of our offenses. From your holy dwelling place, look down upon the dear present, hearing and division of your rich mercy. Visit us in your goodness. Free us from the oppression of evil and make our lives secure within your holy and sacred laws. Entrust your people to a faithful guardian angel. Gather us all into your kingdom. Grant forgiveness to those who come with you. Remit them and us our sins. Cleanse us with the work of your Holy Spirit. Burn them to the wild of the enemy. Blessed are you, Master Almighty Lord, for you light the day with the light of the sun, and light bright the night with the rays of fire. You enabled us to pass this man of the day, and you so come to the beginnings of the night to hear our prayer, and that of all your people, and forgive us all our deliberate unworthy sins. Receive our meaning, which is descend upon your inheritance, the abundance of your mercy and compassion. Encompass us with your holy angels, arm us with the weapons of your righteousness, fortify us with your truth. Make your strength our garrison, spare us all adverse circumstances, all assaults the adversary. Finally, God, save us this day and the impending night, purgatory, peaceful, sinless, free of destroying visions, and all the days of our lives, in the prayers of the Holy Theotokos, all saints who have pleased you through the angels.
Help us, save us, and mercy on us, and raise up the key of God into your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember the most holy, most blessed, glorious Lady the Theotokos and the Virgin Mary, with all the saints that have commit ourselves and one another, on our life into Christ our God.
Lord,
for you are the sure mercy, and today says, save, O Christ our God, unto you we offer up to glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Again, and bend down knees and let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus Christ, O God, who bestowed your grace on and peace on humankind, on the gift of the Holy Spirit to be with us even in this last life, as a perpetual inheritance of believers, never to be taken away. On this day you have sent this grace upon your disciples and apostles away for manifest, giving utterance to the lips by means of fiery tongues, so that every human race, hearing it in own language, receive the knowledge of God and illumined by the light of the Spirit, emerge from their ashes from darkness and the distribution of visible tongues and fire, and by extraordinary bowing, grief, were taught faith in you, and were enlightened to speak of you as of the Father and the Holy Spirit, as one God and one power and sovereignty, as a reflection of the Father, perfect and immutable, likeness of his essence and nature, the source of salvation, raising from the lips of the sinner, and teach me how and for what I should pray, for you know the great number of my sins, yet your compassion will overcome their enormity. For in fear I stand before you, casting my soul to despair and to see your mercy. Govern my life as you govern all creation by the unspoken word, and the power of wisdom, in calm haven of the storm tossed, and make it known to me in which I should walk. Grant me the spirit of wisdom in my thoughts, the spirit of prudence in my ignorance. Let the spirit of the awe of you overshadow my deeds, renew a steadfast spirit in my breast, and let your guiding spirit make firm my erring mind, to that each day led by your good spirit towards that which is possible, I may be more you to keep your commandments, ever mindful of your glory and so certainly present. Do not allow me to be beguiled by the world's corrupting delights, but rather to desire the enjoyment of future great treasures. For you, Master, have said that whatever we ask in your name, we shall without fail receive from your co-eternal God and Father. Thus I, through the sinner and the descendant of your Holy Spirit, beseech your goodness, all that I have asked, grant me for salvation. Yes, Lord, you are the Lamb, the giver of everything good, giving far in excess of what we ask. You are the compassionate, merciful one, who through sins of sinners became a sharer in our faith, and bending in our love towards those who bend the knee to you, you became the propitiation of our sins. Now then, Lord, grant your people your mercies. Hear us from your heavenly dwelling place, sanctify them by the power of your saving right hand. Shelter them in the shadow of your wings. Do not spurn the work of your hands. It is against you alone, let me sin. For it is you alone we worship. We know no alien God no more. Knoweth not to stretch out our hands to any other deity. O Master, we lift our advances, and as you receive our petitions, on bending knee, extend to us all a helping hand. Accept our common prayer as a pleasing presence, rising us up to you.
save us in every hour also in the flat fleece, and the day of the protect us from every everlasting to the Lord, so the dog is accepted and lifted hands of the ark, and he'll be sacrificed and unable to the passive course of night blamelessly, and tempted by evil and the riddle of their disturbance of the fear and use of the evil one. Grant contrition to our souls and to our thoughts, through concern to our trial to the day of our also and judge just judgment. Thanks to the bodies that we are all that end of the earth, early members, until I have quiet to the sleep, into my shield, the contemplation of the judgment, distance from the old, every improper imagining and harmful desires, intense that raise up in the hours of prayer, strengthen our faith and growing into thy commandments.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Holy, most blessed, glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and every Virgin Mary, with all the saints that have commit ourselves and one another on our life into Christ our God. By the favor of the grace of the only begotten Son, who are blessed together with thy good and caring Spirit, now and forever and unto the end of ages.
Praise you, my God, you are our immortal body, and our purple light, and wisdom, you created the world, you set greater light in darkness, and set the sun, the greater light through the day, and the lesser light than when the stars of the night. You have judged us, those sinners, at this present hour to come into your presence, giving thanks and offering you our praise. Loving Lord, let our prayer rise and live before you, and accept it as a fragrant offering. Make this day and the coming night peaceful for us. Gird us with the armor of light, give us the terror of the night, and we that works about the darkness, and let our sleep, which you have given us for rest, given our weakness, free of all demonic images, yea, master of all sorts of oppressions, so that even as we swim in our beds, we may speak your name in the night, and so enlightened by the contemplation of your statue, may rise our souls to joy, to glorify your goodness, offering prayers of creation to our pure compassion for our sins and those of all people. Ask that the decision of the earth, we show them mercy, help us, save us, and mercy us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Amen.
Lord, in the words of all thy blessed words, lay it down, Lord. Commend ourselves, each other, and our lives unto Christ our God. You are the King of peace, we save our souls in you, we pour up glory to the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of all ages. This time we'd like to receive your expression and your reflection of your love for Jesus and for this holy church. I want to thank God, especially that the rain has a little bit let up. After you participate in this love offering, you'll be asked to stand and please take out one of the yellow laminate cards that you can pray together the prayers of thanksgiving to receiving the Holy Communion. And after that, I'd like to share some thoughts with you.
Please stand and pray with me these post-communion prayers. Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee, O God, glory to thee, O God. I thank thee, O Lord my God, that thou hast not rejected me, a sinner. Let us count me worthy to become a communicant of thy holy mysteries. I thank thee that thou hast counted me, the unworthy, worthy to partake of thy immaculate heavenly gifts. But, O Master, who lovest mankind, who didst both die for us and did rise again, and didst bestow upon us these terrible and life-giving mysteries for the benefiting and sanctification of our souls and bodies. Grant that they may be for me also unto the healing of soul and body, unto the averting of everything contrary thereto, the enlightenment of the eyes of my heart, unto the peace of my spiritual powers, unto faith invincible, unto love unfeigned, unto fulfilling of wisdom, unto the keeping of thy commandments, and unto growth of thy divine grace, and the attainment of thy kingdom.